Hi friends, in this video we are going to see how to use source transformation and get an answer that is current flowing through a particular resistor. So let's take a problem. Let's give value to all the resistors and sources. So let's take this as a 10 ampere. This is 10 ohm, 3, 5, this is 10 volt, 1 ohm, and this is 30 volt. We have to find out current flowing through the 10 ohm using source transformation. Now I can say this current source is given, but the problem is that if I consider this current source, this 10 ohm, though its value will remain same, but its orientation will be lost. What does that mean? I want this value of resistor should remain as it is till the last step in a problem. So I cannot touch this, hence I cannot consider this 10 ampere for a conversion. So only left part is this. Now here also, if I see properly, this positive polarity is connected to this positive polarity. So these two voltage sources are in series opposition, meaning I can subtract them and get a equivalent voltage source of this polarity, because 30 is greater than 10. So I can consider 30 minus 10 and the polarity is same as 30. Remaining part of the circuit I will keep as it is. So 10 ampere as it is, 10 ohm, 3, 5, 1 ohm will come in series with 30 minus 10, 20 volt, and our objective is to get this current I. Now this voltage source I can convert into equivalent current source. So converting 20 volt voltage source into equivalent current source. As we have discussed, I cannot touch this. One ohm will come in parallel with 20 divided by 1. So the current value will also be 20 ampere. So I will have 10 ohm, 3 ohm, 5, 1, and this will be 20 divided by 1, 20 ampere, and we are supposed to find out this current I. As we have discussed, whenever I am converting any source to some different source, I need to be assured that circuit will be modified. So the modification in this circuit is 5 coming in parallel with this 1 ohm. So the equivalent is 5 comes in parallel with the 1 ohm, and I will get answer 5 multiplied by 1 divided by 5 plus 1. So it's a 5 by 6, and the answer I will get is 0.8333 ohm. So I will redraw the circuit. Ten ampere as it is, 10 ohm is also remain as it is, 3 as it is, 5 comes in parallel with 1 ohm, and the resultant is 0.8333, and current source is 20 ampere. Now I can convert this current source into equivalent voltage source. So converting 20 ampere current source into equivalent voltage source. So the voltage value will be 0.8333 multiplied by 20. So I will get 16.6667 volt. Now I will redraw the circuit. .8333 will come in series, and this will get converted into a voltage source like this. Rest of the part of the circuit will remain as it is. Now a slight modification will be there. These two will come in series, and the resultant resistor will be 3.8333 ohm. Let's redraw the circuit. . 10 ampere 10 ohm, this value will be 3.8333, and here it will be 16.6667 volt, and we are supposed to find out this value of current I. Now again I can convert this voltage source into equivalent current source. So converting 16.6667 volt into equivalent current source. So value of current I will be 16.6667 divided by 3.8333. The value I will get is 4.3487 ampere. Let's redraw the circuit. So 10 ampere as it is, 10 ohm also as it is, this 3.8333 will come in parallel, and equivalent current source will have the value 4.3487 ampere. Now this value I am supposed to find out I. Now I can say here this 10 ampere and this 4.3487 are in parallel because nothing is connected between them. So 10 ampere and 4.3487 ampere are in parallel, so resultant current or equivalent current will be addition of 10 and 4.3487, which will give you 14.3487 ampere. And I can redraw the circuit now. So it will be 14.3487 ampere, and I am having two resistors, one is 10 ohm and another is 3.8333 ohm. And here I can use a current divider rule. So by current divider rule I can say current flowing through the 10 ohm resistor will be equal to the resistor which is in parallel with 10. So it is 3.8333 divided by addition of two resistors connected in parallel multiplied by total current supplied. So in this case it is 14.3487 ampere. And after solving this, I will get a value 3.9761 ampere. So sometimes it may happen that even if you are converting one source to another, there won't be a much difference in the circuit. It will be a slight difference. So that's what we have seen in this problem. So what happens whenever you convert voltage to current? So it's like only resistors are getting clubbed and number of loops are getting reduced till the last step, where I can use a direct current divider rule and get an answer. So here we have seen that source transformation can be applicable to a complicated network also, or a network which requires lot of source transformations. Thank you.